So as a neighborhood, though, as I mentioned, I grew up here. I was born here, raised here. My family lives here. My aunts and uncles live here. And there's a local grammar school that actually a bunch of us and folks went to and graduated from, Gary Elementary School. And it was actually there that this organization started. And it was because parents in the school, just like a lot of our community members, are blue-collar workers. They do construction. They do windows. They do... Our master gardener builds Victoria's Secrets and Home Depots for a living, right? Like, this is what a lot of our folks do. And so when the school decided to retar the roof of the school and replace all the windows, they did not take account children being in summer school when the roof was retarred. Oh, our school does not have air conditioning, so the windows were open. And many of our students passed out or had asthma attacks because of it. They also then replaced the windows of the school, but did not account for asbestos and lead. And so as the dust was exposed all over the school, the janitor was simply cleaning it up with regular cleaning products. And so it was our parents who came together and said, this is not, there's OSHA. Like, there's rules to this. This is not how you do these things. And so they came together and organized against the school and against the principal, just based on the foundation that they knew in their gut, and they also knew from their work experience and life experience that these things were not right. And it was through that organizing and through that pressure that they were able to get the roof to stop being built during that time. But they also managed to get all 1,000 plus students tested for lead poisoning in the school, which was the first time that had ever happened. And through that organizing, it was actually a representative from US EPA Region 5 that came down, and she was like, look, like, I don't know what you all do, but you all do environmental justice. And we were like, we don't... What the hell is environmental justice? No clue what that is. And she's like, well, you should know that there's countless communities just like yours across the country doing this work, and they're actually based on values. And these are what those values are. And so there's actually 17 principles of environmental justice, which we uphold as an organization, along with the Jimenez principles of democratic organizing. But it was through that experience that folks realized and started to take account to what was happening in their neighborhood. So once they won that victory, they were like, well, shoot, if that's happening, what chemicals is the engineer using? And so we actually did a toxic inventory of the school, and we're able to work out with the school, parents in the school, to get them to stop using toxic chemicals as cleaning agents and to actually start using more natural byproducts that they could create at home. The principals did not like the leadership development we were doing with the parents at the school, and our parents had a little space in the school that they were doing all of this work out of. We were called the Gary School Environmental Justice Project. The principal liked us up until we started to develop leadership in the parents, and they started to ask questions about budgets and questions about hiring and questions about things that were happening in the school. And pretty soon after that, we were thrown out and moved up the block to the Little Village Boys and Girls Club, which is where I interacted with the organization. But as an organization, we've been around, as I mentioned, for 25 years. And through those 25 years, our work has been very much organic. These parents did not set out to come into the neighborhood and tell people what was wrong with them. They saw an issue and started to tackle it. So when they formed an official organization, our first mandate was not to come into the neighborhood and tell people what was wrong with them. Our first mandate was to go out and talk to people. So for the first 3 years of my career here, I spent it going door to door talking to people and asking them, what do you like about the neighborhood? What don't you like about the neighborhood? If you could change anything about the neighborhood. And after those about 2.5, 3 years, we ended up with this enormous list of things that the neighborhood wanted to work on. Now, we were only like 3 organizers and a small budget, and we were like, well, we can't love to tackle all of this, but not gonna happen. So we hosted a community meeting in which about 300 residents came out, and they voted on what the top issues that we should work on are. And those 4 issues were clean air, more parks, better public transit, and rats. I am happy to say we have tackled 3 out of the 4. I don't know if we will ever truly be able to tackle the rat population in the city of Chicago, but we try. So those were our 3 mandates. We didn't really know how to tackle clean air. We didn't really know how we were gonna get more parks, but we knew that that's what our neighborhood wanted, and that's what we were gonna have to do. So that is how we ended up with the campaigns that we have now. And we'll talk a little bit about the different campaigns as we move forward, but just to give you